Okay, picking up from where we left off, and it helps if I turn the volume on. See if you can spot the pattern again. Try not to use your calculator. So first of all, what's 6 times 6? Write down the answer to that. What's 4 times 8? I picked these numbers carefully. Keep your eye open for a pattern. See what you can spot. Liam, what's 9 times 9? What's 7 times 11? Courtney, what's 4 times 4? Yep. What's 2 times 6? Anybody spot a pattern yet? Okay, hold it. So in this next one, the first part of the question, Jordan, what's 7 times 7? Can you tell me what two numbers I would write here in the pattern that I've been trying to develop here? What times what? Emily. Which is what? Spot it, Shay? Okay, so Shay, in this next one, I gave you part two of the question. I said 12 times 16 is 192. What did I do here? What times what? You spot it? If you haven't, that's fine. No calculator, put it away. I don't think you need a calculator to figure out the numbers. Taylor, why 14 times 14? Oh, and what is 14 times 14 without a calculator? 196. Taylor, what was the pattern? On the left side, I was squaring a number. Where did these numbers come from? Two less and two more. What did you notice about the answer? So, if I tell you that 57 times 57 is 3,249, because it is, can you tell me what 55 times 59 is? Really? 3,245. You know what I'm really saying? Here's what I'm really saying. If you take a number and subtract 2 from it, Taylor, that's 2 less. And you take that same number and you add 2 to it, Taylor, that's 2 more. Oh, let's FOIL this out. What is x minus 2 times x plus 2? I'll get x squared, I'll get plus 2x, I'll get minus 2x, I'll get minus 4, in fact, I get x squared minus 4. Now, just so my screen's not so cluttered up, I'm going to delete the loops. And let's see if this is what Taylor said. If you take any number, Jordan, subtract 2 and add 2 and multiply them together, take any number like 6, subtract 2 and add 2 and multiply them together, the answer is 4 less than that number squared. 4 less than that number squared. Is that right? What we've just done is we've proven that difference of squares, which you guys learned last year in grade 9, actually works for numbers. What's 9 times 9? 81. I'm going to go 3 less than. And 3 more than. 3 less than. 3 more than. Now I know the answer is 72, but it's 9 less than this number squared. In fact, if you tell me that 57 times 57 is 3,249, I know that 3 less than, 3 more than, is this answer here, but not minus 4, minus 3 times 3, minus 9. Double check me to see if I'm right, but 54 times 60, it is 3,240, is it not? Check me, Shay. Yep. Where it says proof, there's our actual proof. We said, look, if you take any number and you go two less, and multiply them together, and then Devin, we actually did the FOIL. Oh, that's the same as the original number squared minus 4. Just like earlier, we proved that if you did the same thing here, any number one less, any number one more than, multiply them together, it's the original number squared minus 1. We talked about two classes ago, the term conjecture. There are some conjectures that seem very simple, but have yet to be proved. A very famous one is Goldbach's conjecture. I can explain it to all of you right now. In 1742, Christian Goldbach proposed the following. He said this. Notice the pattern. Any even integer bigger than 2 can be expressed as the sum of two prime numbers. Now, what does the word sum mean? What mathematical operation? Addition. Can you give me an, Aaron, can you give me an even number bigger than 2, less than 50? Okay.
He says that you can write that as the sum of two prime numbers.
What can you write 20 as? What plus? What? 9's not prime. Thank you for playing. Collect your consolation prize at the door. Yeah. 17 plus 3. It works for that one. Ooh, let's go a bit bigger. Give me a number. Bender, give me a number between 20 and 40 that's even. I can't hear you. 20? 30. All right, write that as the sum of two prime numbers. 27. Oh, no, 27 is not prime. Nope. Oh, yeah. 7 plus 23 works. Jeremiah, give me a number between 40 and 60. And even, you know what? Give me a number between 50 and 100, an even number. 76. A little tougher. Oh. I think this. 3 plus what? See, I don't think anything goes into 73. Do you? 2 doesn't go into it, 5 doesn't go into it, 9 doesn't go in. I'm pretty sure 73 is prime. Marcus, give me an even number between 50 and 100. 105 is neither even nor between 50 and 100. So strike 1, strike 2. Give me an even number between 50 and 100. 96, okay. 93, oh no, 3 goes into 93. Oh, I'm pretty sure 91 is prime. I don't recall it ever coming up in my times tables. Do you guys? That's how, by the way, for me to figure out if a number is prime, if it's below 100, I ask, did it ever show up on my times tables? If it didn't, I'm assuming it's prime. And you guys know how to tell if 2 goes into it. Yeah. 91 is not prime. Does 17 go into it? Sorry, 37 goes into it. 7 goes into 91? Oh, it does. Mr. Dueck, you're wrong. We need to find a different one. Thank you, Johnson. Candy for you.
I thought 91 and 5 seemed so great. How about 89 and 7? Does that work? 89 prime. 89 is prime. By the way, raise your hand if you know your 37's times table. Well played. Well played.
So you know what? I think 89 plus 7 works.
It's a very, very simple conjecture. Prove it. We've been trying since 1742. No one's been able yet to find, you know how we did this, like let X be the number and find, no one's been able to come up with a way to do that. If you do, you'll win the Fields Medal, which is a Nobel Prize for mathematics. It's awarded every 4 years. Guarantee you'll win. And I said, as far as I know, as of about 2 weeks ago, it had been, this conjecture had been tested for every number up to a million, billion, trillion, 1,609,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,
computer, it'll just run in the background very, very quietly and continue trying numbers. And, but because those numbers are so big, to do one number now, it takes a fair bit of number crunching. When you're in the trillions, you got to test every possibility. It takes a while. It's funny, I looked around, I see about four of you on your calculators trying. Yeah. So conjectures, Shania, don't have to be really tough and confusing to be very tough to prove. In fact, this is a fairly simple one. Any even number, you can write it as 1 prime plus 1 prime. Oh, sorry, any even number bigger than 2. Prove it. Many people have tried. Feel free to try. You might have spot, you may figure something that we haven't.
What's your homework? Hold on. Turn the page.
I've seen many a magician perform this mind-reading trick here. So it says this. A number of mentalists perform the following mind-reading trick. Get your calculators out. See if you can do this with me. Choose a number from 1 to 9. Marcus, that means 11 is no good. Multiply that number by 9 and then press equals on your calculator. Look at the answer that you have in front of you. Add both of the digits together. So, for example, if you got 15, you would go 1 plus 5 is 6. I'm about to tell you. Add both of the digits together and subtract 5 from that number. So type in the answer that you got when you added the digits together, minus 5. And then look at the answer that's in front of you. Find the alphabet letter that matches your numbers. So if you have a 1, that would be an A. If you have a 2, that would be a B. If you have a C, that would be a 3. A 3, that would be a C, etc. Think of a country that begins with that letter. Remember that. Add 5 to the number that's on your calculator, the number that you had before you matched a letter to it. And once you've added 5, find the letter that it matches. Again, A being 1, B being 2, C being 3, etc. And think of a mammal that begins with that letter. So you should have a country that begins with the first number, first letter that we got. And you should have a mammal. A mammal is a warm-blooded animal. And then the punchline most magicians give is they say, hey, wait a minute. There are no elephants in Denmark. How many of you had that? Only one of you? I think some of you couldn't follow the math. Most, well, when you do the first one, pardon me? Because you got a D. All of you, for that first letter, got a 4. Okay? What countries begin with D? Now, it's a little tougher because you're teenagers and you're stupid in geography. You don't know much. What countries begin with D? That Dominican Republic is the other obscure one, which I was prepared for. I might have had that as a backup. Now, we have a German here who said Deutschland. His country in German begins with D. We're saying English, you know. What other countries begin with D? And by the way, how many people will think of Dominican Republic? Not that many. There's two more. But only two. And they're really obscure. In fact, I can't remember the second one. Can't remember what was the first one. It is the D, it's A, it's one of the Indonesian small countries that change all the time. They're sort of the Democratic Republic of Congo, but that really begins with a C for Congo. So most people are going to come up with Denmark. Then it says add five. You know what? When you added five, I think that's wrong. I think this is a typo. I think you should add one because you're supposed to end up on an E. And you're supposed to think of a mammal that begins with an E. And if I was really trying to sell you, if I was really trying to do this, Courtney, here's what I would say. Think of a mammal, big or small, that begins with your letter. And by emphasizing the word big, almost everyone's going to pick an elephant. In fact, I could even just say, think of an animal, big or small. What animals begin with E? It's five of them that aren't really obscure. Elephant. What other animals begin with an E? Fly like an eagle. Now, if I emphasize the word big, that probably takes care of that one. There are two more that I know of. Ah, three more. I stand corrected. Elk. Emu, which is like an ostrich, but not an ostrich. And then how many of you know what an echidna is? It's a shrew. It's like a mini little groundhog mouse. It's a cross between a mouse and a hamster. So a lot of magicians do some modification of this. It's like, wow, how'd you read my mind? No, just knowing the odds or playing the odds. Except it works better if the trick that I copied from the internet didn't have a typo in it. I should have run through this myself to make sure that the typo didn't work.
If you're bored for a candy, if you prove to me how this trick works, if you let the number be X and follow it all the way through, this one is fairly tough. I'll give you a candy when I see you on Tuesday. What did I say the homework was? So turn, if you would, please, to lesson two in your book. Page 76. Okay. Homework. Preferably turn a little quicker to page 76. Who am I glaring at who forgot their book again? No, we're doing pretty good, I think. So number one, this is how we started out last day with little truth statements. So Leona lives in a 100-mile house. 100 miles is in British Columbia. What can you conclude? Number two, here is one of those number puzzles. It says complete columns, choice one, choice two. Try it for three different numbers. And you should notice a pattern in your answer when you're done. It may be the same answer, or it may look very similar with only slight differences. I haven't tried this one yet. So B says make a conjecture based on your answers in columns 1, 2, and 3 with the three ones that you've tried. And then C says use deductive reasoning to complete the column in the general case. So they're saying let the number be N. And try following this one all the way through algebraically, like we did last day for this one here. See if you can do it. We used X instead of M, but Matt, it's the same idea. Okay. So two all, good. Number three. There are no answers in the back for these. We will go over these next class. So the answers for one and two are in the back. These are tough. If you can't get these, do not despair. It means you're normal. See if you can prove the sum of any three consecutive even numbers is divisible by 6. Now, what are consecutive even numbers? 6 plus 8 plus 10. Or 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 6. By the way, what is 2 plus 4 plus 6? 12. Does 6 go into 12? What is 6 plus 8 plus 10? 24. Does 6 go into 24? Apparently it always will. Prove it. Here's your hint. I think I would let the first number be x. What would the second number be then? How do you go from a 2 to a 4? Add 2. What would the second number be then? If the first number is x, what would the second number be? X plus 2. What would the third number be then? Not x plus 2. How do you go from a 2 to a 6? How do you go from a 6 to a 10? Try adding those three together, gathering like terms, and see if you notice anything. Okay? Same with B, except B is going to be any odd numbers. Oh. This said consecutive even numbers. If I really want to guarantee they're even, you know what I should do? I should call the number 2x and 2x plus 2 and 2x plus 4. Why will that guarantee that they're even? Think about it. For B, three odd numbers is an odd number. I would call the odd numbers 2x plus 1, 2y plus 1, and 2z plus 1. There's your three odd numbers. How do I know those are odd? We said last day, take an even number and add 1 to it. Now it's odd. See what happens if you try adding those three gather-like terms. What do you notice? Again, if you're finding this tough, you're normal. C says the product of any two odd numbers is an odd number. Try and prove that 2x plus 1 multiplied by 2y plus 1 will always be odd. Try foiling that out and see what you notice. D says the difference of the squares of two consecutive even numbers is divisible by 4. Huh? Here's 8. Here's 10. Those are two consecutive even numbers. What's 8 squared? 8 squared? 8 times 8. Yeah, no calculator. 10 squared. What's 100? Take away 64. It's saying this number, this answer, will always be divisible by 4. Does 4 go into 36? Prove that that will always work for any two consecutive even numbers. And these are tough. We'll spend a lot of time next class talking about these. I'm going to pause there. I'm going to nuke number 4. Can you turn back one lesson, please, to lesson 1, inductive reasoning? We went through these. Want you to make sure you didn't finish these last class. Looks like you hadn't started these. Make sure you finish those. And then the remainder of class, last day, I gave out an investigation. Oh, let me hit pause because I'm done the lesson part. Right click.